Welcome to the BPS Hour of Code. My name is Haruna Hosokawa from the Digital Learning Team. I will be introducing you to Scratch and the 10 Blocks Challenge, which is one of the 8 student contests that BPS has organized for this year's Hour of Code. Before we get started with the 10 Blocks Challenge, we will go over some basics in Scratch. To get the Scratch, go to scratch.mit.edu. You don't have to create an account, but if you do, you will be able to save, share, and remix projects. The Create tab takes you to the online programming interface, which consists of 4 main areas. The stage is where your animation or game will take place. You can set your own background for the stage. Characters or objects are called sprites. There are hundreds of sprites available in the library, or you can design your own. You can have more than one sprite in your program. Down the middle of the screen are the blocks or commands. Think of this area as your toolbox. The blocks are organized in color-coded menus, depending on the function of the blocks. To create a program, you drag a block from your toolbox to the script area. The blocks snap together to form a script. A script defines how a sprite or character will behave. When you don't need a block anymore, you can put it back into the blocks area in the middle. Now you can see that there are a lot of different blocks available. In the 10 Blocks Challenge, we've simplified the task to use just a specific set of 10 blocks to create an animation in Scratch. For the BPS 10 Blocks Challenge, the 10 allowed blocks are the go-to block, to move a sprite to a specific location on your stage, the glide to block, which also moves the sprite but does so in a slower way, the wait block to add a delay in your program, the repeat block, which repeats a specific set of codes for a specified number of times, the say block, which makes the character speak with a speech bubble, the change size to, set size to block to change the size of the sprite, the show and hide blocks to show and hide the sprite, the play sound until done block to introduce different sound effects, and finally, the when green flag is clicked block. This is a trigger block that starts any script that is attached to this block when you click on the green flag at the top of the screen. Your task is to use these 10 blocks to create a Scratch animation. You can use each block once, twice, or as many times as you need, but each block must be used at least once, and you must not use any other blocks. If you have done Scratch before, you can stop the video now and start programming. If you'd like to see an example before you start, continue on with the video and you will see what each block does as I create an animation using the 10 blocks. The first step in creating a program is to choose a sprite. Remember, sprite is a character or an object in your animation. You can use the cat, but I'm going to delete it and pick something else. To delete the cat, simply right-click on it and choose Delete. To add another sprite, click on Choose Sprite from Library button. This opens up a library of sprites that are built into Scratch. For my animation, I'm choosing the crab. You can have as many sprites as you want, but right now I'm gonna just have one sprite. Next, I'm gonna pick a background by clicking on Choose Background from Library button. I'm using the beach for my animation. Once you have a background, you can drag and drop your sprite to wherever you want on the stage. Now we're ready to start programming. To begin programming, click on the Scripts tab in the middle of the screen. It's a good practice in Scratch to always start with the green flag block, which happens to be one of the 10 blocks that we need to use. This allows the script to start when you click on the green flag at the top of your screen. Next, I'm going to use the go-to blocks to move the crab from the left side of the screen to the right and back to the left. The X and Y coordinates on the block tells the program where to put the crab. The middle of your stage is 0, 0. So currently my crab is at minus 150 and minus 101. To move it to the right side of the screen, I'm going to change the X value to a positive number so it goes to the other side of the screen. And because I want it to go back, I'm going to duplicate the first one to make it go back. To test out your script, you can simply click on the blocks to test out each command. Once you're happy with them, you can snap them together. But notice that my crab doesn't appear to be moving right now. That is because the program is running too fast for my eyes to see that the crab is actually moving. To fix this, I'm going into the control menu and adding a wait block. The wait block adds a delay in the program. So now I can see that the crab is actually starting on the left, moving to the right, and coming back to the left. By the way, it's always a good idea to test scripts a little bit at a time. Don't wait until you write a big long script to test it out, because it's much easier to debug or troubleshoot a short script than a long one. Next, I'm going to use the glide to block to make the crab go to the right side of the screen again. But this time it's going to do it slowly because the glide to block lets you control how long it takes for the crab to move. So first it'll move fast, and then it's going to move slowly to the right side of the screen. So far I've used 4 of the 10 blocks: the green flag block, the go-to block, the wait block, and the glide to block. Next, I'm going to the looks menu to use the set size to block. This block lets you change the size of the sprite. Once again, I'm going to add a wait block in between each command to make sure the program runs a little bit slowly. I'm also going to add a repeat block to repeat this code 3 times. Once I like this piece of code, I will snap it together with the rest of my program. Now I've used 6 of the 10 blocks: green flag, go to, glide, wait, repeat, and set size. Next, I'm going to go into the looks menu again and use hide and show. And I'm going to do the same thing I did with the resize blocks. So I will add some delay and repeat it 3 times. Next, I will use the play sound block in the sound menu. The play sound block comes with a default sound effect, pop in this case, but I'm going to choose a different sound by going into the sounds tab. Click on Choose Sound from Library to open up a library of available sound effects. You can test out the sounds by clicking on the play button. Once you find one that you like, you can click on OK to add it to your program. Once you have added this to your program, the new sound will appear as a choice in the play sound block. Now we just have one more block left to use, the say block. A say block adds a speech bubble. It doesn't actually produce any sound. I'm going to use the say block to add some narration in my program. And I'm going to add a green flag block at the top of the narration to make sure the narration starts at the same time as my animation. And notice I'm testing out the code a little bit at a time to make sure the timings match. So there you have it. That is my 10 blocks challenge. I've used all 10 blocks to create an animation of a crab moving around on the beach. Once you're done, you can click on the share button at the top of the screen to share your project. Just be mindful that when you share, your project is available for the whole world to see. So be sure not to include any personal information. You can also go to tiny.cc.bps 10 blocks to see more examples of programs created with these 10 blocks. We'll be adding more examples as we go on. You can open up any of these examples and see the code by clicking on the See Inside button. And don't forget to enter the BPS 10 Blocks Challenge contest between December 7th and 11th for your chance to win great prizes. Have fun and good luck!